It's been 2 weeks and the results are in. This video presents to you the coronavirus situation before and after the recent protests in the United States. Let's start. The American people did not stay at home. Instead, they took to the streets fighting for a greater cause, Black Lives Matter. In the past few weeks, and especially after the United States protest had started, almost every day we see major media platforms trying to get our attention by saying that the COVID-19 cases are rising and that there is an alarming number of cases in the United States, etc. Maybe they want to blame that on the protests or on lifting the lockdown or stay-at-home orders, which were actually lifted in many of the American states before and around May 15th, 2020. Here are some of the risk factors we may find in protests: overcrowding, shouting and yelling at close range, lack of physical distancing, physical contact with law enforcement or other protesters. Not everyone is wearing a mask, high levels of stress and probability of sleep deprivation, lack of drinking water, etc., which may all increase the risk of infection with COVID-19 as well as the severity of the disease, supposedly. Today, we will do a quick and basic but proper comparison between the number of cases 12 days before the protests and the number of cases 12 days after the protests in the United States in general, not state by state. You all know from my other videos that I'm not a fan of looking at the number of cases, but that's the number that has been misused lately by the media, and I plan to examine it in a more reasonable manner statistically. The number of cases is not a good indicator because it changes every day based on the number of tests being done, simply because no country conducts the exact number of tests every day. This means that I cannot compare the number of cases yesterday to the number of cases today because the number of tests done was different. That's why I had to dig deeper into the data. You know, public health doctors love data. But personally, I'm a bit allergic to math, so I had to call my friend and colleague Dr. Farid, who is a genius PhD scholar at a Japanese university, and asked for his help. He suggested we do a basic normalization, that is to divide the number of positive cases per day by the number of tests done on the same day to get a percentage of positive cases during a period of time. This way, we can make a fair comparison. We did the effort on your behalf and on behalf of the media, and we got a nice clean set of data for the ratios of COVID-19 positive cases in the United States 12 days before and after the protests. Still, we cannot just look at those numbers and draw conclusions. But to give you an easy to understand result, we need to get the average of each set of data before and after to decide if there is a significant difference. Based on our calculations, the average ratio of positive cases normalized from May 20th to May 31st, 2020 was 5.1%, and the average ratio of positive cases from June 1st to June 12th was 4.7%. Next, we need to do a basic statistical test. We call it the Ttest, which is a test done to check if there is a significant difference between the average or mean of the ratio of positive cases before and the average of the ratio of positive cases after the protests. We did that test using a software. The result came out as you see them on the screen. And to say this result in English, there was no significant difference between the average number of coronavirus cases in the United States 12 days before the protests and 12 days after the protests, based on the data collected during that period of time. We also conducted a quick test of association called rate ratio test. There is a link in the description about this test from the CDC. The rate ratio test showed us that the risk of contacting coronavirus during the 12 days after the protests was lower than that during the 12 days before the protests. There is no causality here, just association. The number of fatalities gave us similar results, by the way, even lower. But I need to warn you that as of today, June 15th, it may be a bit early to look at the fatalities. Once more, this video was about the United States as a whole, not state by state. I'm not going to give any conclusions in this video. I want you to rewatch it carefully and give me your own conclusions in the comment section. I'll see you next video.